So some of you may ask, what's the benefit of linear regression being a class? So you can see it's a class and it comes from this module. And then this is the main module. So sklearn is the main module. And then you have the submodule. And then within this module, you have a class called linear regression. And when we import this class in over here, then what we can do is we can actually use that class, initiate that class. So here, for example, I'll delete this previous code over here. So you can see linear regression over here. And we're storing it in this variable. So by using this, what we're doing is we are initiating the class. So this is going to, imagine you have a cake recipe. As soon as you start to put it together, you read the full recipe and try and understand it. This is what this is doing. This is initiating the class to for it to be ready to accept data. So it's like having a cake mold, a cake template, which you're going to put the ingredients into. It's just getting that template ready for that cake before you put the ingredients in the pot or in the mold. So once you have that, you've initiated this over here. So you now have a copy of it. So you're not working with the original class here anymore. So that's the original, that's just a template. So once you have that template, you can think of it like an Excel template as well. So you could create an Excel workbook of a template or a Word, you know, you could set up a Word template, but then use it to create several documents. That's as soon as you start to use that template, I mean, go to File and click new from template. And then once you have a document in front of you, that's where we are. So a blank Excel workbook. And then you can use things like model.fit because model here is referring to that particular copy of this class. And here you're using the fit function and passing it to parameters. And then later on, when you then use model.predict, it's aware of its data that you've already passed it because you had this data, size and the price. You converted it into X and Y. So size becomes X variable and price becomes the Y variable. And then you pass these over here and it will go and create the model. And then you can use the predict function because the predict function will have all the data it used to for this fit function. And then it's able to predict the house price over here by supplying it a size. And then you can do other things, you know, find out the coefficient and the intercept values as well, because these are the variables stored within that class, but they are aware of your data. So they know. So it's like the Excel template. It might be blank. Once you start filling in your data in Excel, then it will be your data that expects back. So for example, in cell B3, if you input your data, then B3 will say, ah, that's your data in that cell. So it's no longer blank. It actually has the data that you input into that file, but the file that you created from the template. So I hope this explains why we have classes for linear regression and not module.